Hi, it's Aurora. Today, for art, I'm going to show you how to make your own game with things that you have at home. Are you ready?
For this art project, you will need cardboard, textured paper, any material for the slides, I used pipe cleaners, any material for the letters, I used paper clips, glue, and scissors. If you want, you could also use an empty tissue box, paper, beads or buttons, and tape. First, I cut my textured paper into small squares. These will be the game spaces. Next, I glued the small squares onto my piece of cardboard in a board game pattern. If you use a hot glue gun like I did, please be careful. Here's my board game after I added some Velcro to each square. I also put labels on. Now for the fun part. You get to decide where your chutes and ladders will go. I used a hot glue gun to glue down my pipe cleaners and paper clips. If you do the same, please be careful. Before I could start playing my new game, I needed to get a game piece. You can use really anything for a game piece, but I decided to have fun with it. I added a piece of Velcro to the bottom. First, I traced my tissue box to figure out how big my square should be. Then I used my scissors to cut out 6 squares. Here's how to add movement to your new game. If you roll a 1, do 1 jump. If you roll a 2, do 2 tiptoes. If you roll a 3, stretch side to side 3 times. If you roll a 4, touch the floor 4 times. If you roll a 5, bend your knees 5 times. If you roll a 6, do 6 marches. To finish making my dice, I used a hot glue gun to glue my construction paper squares on each side. Next, I added my number and movement symbols as well as Braille. But you can really do this part however you want. Another idea is using buttons or beads to represent the numbers. I also decided to add tape to cover up any visible parts of the tissue box. Thank you. Now I'm ready to play.
Thank you for doing art with me today. I am so excited to play my new game. I hope that you enjoy playing. If you play, email me pictures or videos. Bye. See you soon.